I was reading a devotional a few weeks ago that reminded me about how people have been gathering for millennium on this night where darkness threatens to overtake the light, the longest night of the year. This night, more than many, it seems to invite people to ponder on the nature of darkness and light, of good and bad, of hope and despair, whether darkness might overshadow everything good in our lives or if light will truly come again to renew our lives. We here don't wonder as the ancients did if the sun will die and fail to return, but we do, like them, gather in the darkness of this longest night to name our own darkness, to name our own fear, our own grief. And we gather as an act of faith that the glory of the Lord, that the light of Christ will rise among us. That as Isaiah said, even though darkness might cover the earth and a thick darkness the people, that the Lord will arise in our midst as the breaking of the dawn. Tonight is the night that we celebrate Christ with us, Emmanuel. Among those of us listening today, perhaps there are those among us who've had a loved one die. Perhaps your family is a dysfunctional mess. Maybe home for you is far away and you're alone for the holidays. Maybe this is just a difficult time of year. Perhaps you struggle with depression and this season just magnifies or amplifies it. Or maybe you're just curious what a blue Christmas service is. We gather here tonight because we acknowledge that the only road through the darkness into the light is through the honesty of tears and grief. It's by owning and experiencing the full spectrum of complex emotions that we feel as human beings who are alive. We acknowledge that the only way to true, deep, and profound joy is authenticity and honesty. And so we take this time to be honest with ourselves and to be honest with God tonight and to come with that authenticity and vulnerability as we celebrate the vulnerability of the incarnate Christ. Christmas was placed on December 25th in order to coincide with the solstice celebrations. It was the night that the darkness was at its strongest and the light was most needed. And in that moment, people gathered. People found family and friends to light a fire of hope around fellowship and gratitude. And that's what we do this night. We gather to celebrate the light that shines in the darkness with a spirit of gratitude towards God, Emmanuel, Christ incarnate. We are never alone because God is with us. And we ground ourselves in the truth that God enacted divine love and mercy in a small baby boy. We come together to say today that it's okay to feel blue when everything around us is decorated with tinsel, green, red, and gold. It's okay to be sad in the midst of a season of merriment, but it's also okay to be joyful even when we feel grief or feel sadness. It's okay to celebrate when times are hard, and it's okay to share moments of laughter even when we're in the midst of illness and grief. This gathering and all gatherings of people in the church this season are wrapped and swaddled in the good news of God in Christ incarnate. We gather together, cradled in infinite love and mercy, to offer God our honest, unfiltered selves, which is all that God has ever wanted from us. This service is one that's largely prayer and reflection and song. It's a time for us to come before the Lord. There is no sermon. We will be celebrating communion and we'll be inviting the light of Christ coming to be kindled in our hearts. So as we do so, let's join together in singing before we transition to the lighting of the Advent candle wreath. Let's sing together in the bleak midwinter. Thank you. tonight we light the Christ candle. Standing here in the center of the wreath is the central candle that represents Jesus, Emmanuel, God with us, who is the anchor of our hope, the bedrock of our peace, the fountain of our joy, and the source of all love. Jesus, who was born as a helpless baby and who hears our cries, who understands what weakness and helplessness feels like. Jesus is the good shepherd who knows our hearts. Jesus, who will reign over a kingdom, one day where there will be no more sickness or death or crying or pain for all eternity. The Jesus we celebrate today is the one who is given the Holy Spirit to help and comfort and guide us until that day. So we light the Christ candle as we welcome Christ to be the center of our lives and at home in our hearts. Please join with me in singing, "Let All Mortal Flesh Keep Silent."
God of light and life, we light this candle for all those who are struggling with issues involving physical or mental health. We especially remember those struggling with cancer, depression, or thoughts of suicide. May its light remind us all of the healing available to us in Christ Jesus. Hear our prayers that anguish be minimized and your good plan fulfilled for each who suffers.
light this candle for all of those who are struggling with issues involving financial concerns, job loss, and seemingly insurmountable debt. May its light remind us all that you are the great provider, that you will give us our daily bread. We ask that you would empower us to take the steps that we need to solve these problems, draw us to the right people and programs to help us, open doors of opportunity that your glory might be revealed in our places of need.
We light this candle for those who are suffering the consequences of war, famine, and unbridled disease. May its light remind us of your holy calling to everyone who believes you are the light of the world. Change the hearts of all who resort to violence, who seek revenge. Protect those who find themselves far from home, serving their nations or the needy. We know you are in the midst of those in anguish and pray that your healing presence will be seen, felt, and embraced. Reveal to us how to join in your saving work to make tangible gifts to alleviate suffering, to support those on the front lines of natural and man-made disasters, to pray unceasingly for peace in our families, our neighborhoods, and our world.
Light this candle for all who wrestle with the chains of addiction. Help us to name that which enslaves us and to face it. Food, alcohol, drugs, pornography, shopping, escapism, self-medication, self-abuse in all its forms. May this candle bring your light to those secret and not so secret activities of imprisonment. Hear our prayers for deliverance and freedom. Help us and those we love break the hold of these evils.
We light this candle for all those who are victims of violence in any of its forms. May its light lead us to peace safety, and truth. Pour forth encouragement to claim your help in healing physically and spiritually, to trust in your justice, to find assistance, to resist blaming ourselves, to be confident in the future you have planned for us, a future full of hope, and the grace to pursue it.
Light this candle for all those who grieve. You know our deepest need. You understand our pain. Lost dreams, lost opportunities, the separation of death. May its light remind us that we are not orphaned, we are not alone. Grant us grace that in pain we might find comfort, in sorrow hope, and in death resurrection.
Light this candle for all those who are experiencing the pain of broken relationships with family, children, spouses, and friends. May its light remind us of the pure communion you desire for all your creation. Our desire for this same communion makes estrangement so painful. Lead us to relinquish the hold broken relationships have on us, to forgive ourselves for our contribution to the breach, to forgive those who have hurt us, to take the steps to mend that relationship, if possible. Lord, we know that sometimes we suffer from a broken relationship with someone who is now dead. Help us to prayerfully examine, receive, and extend forgiveness in that situation, that we may live again.
Light this candle for all who are estranged from you, who are besieged with doubts, who are overwhelmed by the world and do not claim your presence in their lives. We pray for them and for ourselves, for we confess that each of us knows this condition. Lord, may the light of your love lead us all home to you. We ask these things in the strong name of Jesus. Amen. Please join with me in singing now, "Lo, how a rose ever blooms."
Hear these words of comfort from Psalm 139. O Lord, you have searched me and known me. You know when I sit down and when I rise up. You discern my thoughts from afar. You search out my path and my lying down and are acquainted with all my ways. Even before a word is on my tongue, behold, O Lord, you know it altogether. You hem me in behind and before, and lay your hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me. It is high. I cannot attain it. Where shall I go from your spirit? Or where shall I flee from your presence? If I ascend to heaven, you are there. If I make my bed in Sheol, you are there. If I take the wings of the morning and dwell in the uttermost parts of the sea, even there your hand shall lead me, and your right hand shall hold me. If I say, surely the darkness shall cover me and the light about me be night, even the darkness is not dark to you. The night is bright as the day, for darkness is as light with you. For you formed my inward parts. You knitted me together in my mother's womb. I praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Wonderful are your works, my soul knows it very well. My frame was not hidden from you when I was being made in secret, intricately woven in the depths of the earth. Your eyes saw my unformed substance. In your book were written, every one of them, the days that were formed for me, when as yet there was none of them. How precious to me are your thoughts, O God! How vast is the sum of them! If I would count them, they are more than the sand. I awake, and I am still with you.
God is with us. God is within and around us. Even in our darkness, this light shines in our heart. Even in our grief, we believe that peace can be known. Jesus is Emmanuel, God with us, the Prince of Peace and our eternal hope. Christ is our Comforter, our Savior, our Friend, and our Lord. Christ has come to be born into the world, the light that shines in the darkness, that the darkness can never overcome. In life, Jesus suffered anxiety and fear and pain. Jesus knows well our sorrows and is acquainted with our grief, for he carries them for us.
On the night before he died for us, Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his friends and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." As supper was ending, Jesus took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is poured out for you and for all, for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this in remembrance of me." We take this time to remember what Christ has done for us.
We remember with Mary and Joseph, looking forward to the day of your birth. We remember with shepherds and magi who caught their breath in wonder as they knelt before Emmanuel. We remember with Anna and Simeon who saw you as the fulfillment of all of their hopes and the promises of God for salvation. We remember with your disciples and the crowds who flocked to hear your living words of grace, trusting and believing that you are the long-awaited deliverer, come to set us free. We remember your pain, humiliation, suffering, and death. We remember the cross that you endured that we might be free from the consequence of sin, those we have perpetrated, and those we have fallen victim to. We remember how the news spread that the tomb was empty, that the stone was rolled away, that your body was gone, and how, despite it all, your followers could scarcely bring themselves to hope, afraid to take the risk in faith should they face heartache of losing you once again. It's a fear of loss that we ourselves are all too familiar with. And we remember finally how you appeared in all your risen glory in the garden, in the upstairs room, on the Emmaus Road, by the Sea of Galilee. And the dream was born again, the smoldering embers of faith rekindled in the disciples' hearts. As we partake of the bread and juice, we ask that you would kindle hope and peace and joy and love in our hearts as well.
And as we remember, we ask that you would send your Holy Spirit upon us and upon these gifts of bread and cup, that they may be to us the body and blood of Christ. Grant that we, burning with your Spirit's power, may be a people of compassion, justice, and love. A people of the incarnate Christ. Amen. And now receive this blessing. May this eternal truth be always on our hearts, that the God who breathed this world into being, placed stars into the heavens, and designed a butterfly's wing, is the same God who entrusted his life to the care of ordinary people, became vulnerable that we might know how strong is the power of love, a mystery so deep that it's impossible to grasp, a mystery so beautiful it is impossible to ignore. Amen. Go in peace.